Giants are hanging on to a 6-4 lead here tonight, but their comments are threatening.
I'll tell you, Keller's in more hot water than Aunt Maisie's teabag. Keller deals. And it's ripped up the middle for a base hit. The run will score, and the Peaches' lead has been cut to 6-5.
Time?
Time out on the field.
Are you gonna get someone out?
I thought I got someone out with that ground ball to third, but somehow you managed to spring out of the way.
Hey, it took a bad hop,
all right?
Everything
on your face.
Listen, Bush League, Bush
League.
Hey! One more out and we win. Let's just get it, huh?
Ladies, I retire in 2 years. I would like to finish this game first.
I'll par with a sense of humor. So rarely see that.
Ladies, let's go.
Burn it in there, kid.
Evelyn, come here.
Let's go, ladies.
What do you want me to say?
Who, me? Evelyn, we've been through this. You're not in right field anymore. You're a catcher. You're supposed to call pitches.
I know. But if I call the wrong pitch, Jimmy gets so mad at me. I wish Dottie were here.
We can win without Dottie.
When?
Ladies, let's go.
Evelyn, you're my catcher. You're supposed to give me confidence.
Okay. I like your hair.
Let's go. I'm throwing off out here.
Go.
Let's go. Let's go, Peaches. Come on.
Come on, Kate. You can do it.
Burn it in there. Kate.
Well, it looks like we're actually going to play again.
Throw smoke.
Keller looks in for a sign.
Let's go home early.
Shakes it off.
Looks
in for another.
Let's go.
What'd she do?
Come on, kid.
Trying to confuse the batter.
Let's go.
Folks, that reminds me of a great baseball anecdote. Back in Pittsburgh in 37, maybe it was 35, bumped in the pitch, smashed up the alley in left center. Two runs are going to score, and the Peaches will trail for the first time today.
You know, instead of killing me slowly each day, why don't one of you take this bat and put me out of my misery? Now, who's got the best swing, huh?
Marla.
Marla? Well, why don't you just step right up and let it rip? Right up the middle.
Look, Jimmy, you think we like losing?
You must. You keep doing it. I remember last year. Remember when we actually won some games? Oh, yeah. We had hopes. We had dreams. I don't know. Maybe it's my fault. Maybe I failed. Now, it's you. And you, and you, and you, and you, and you. And not you, Betty. You're doing a terrific job. I'm very proud of you. Keep up the good work. Now, for those of you whose husbands weren't killed during the war, you're not thinking out there. Evelyn! Oh, a moment. Is this a bad time? What was that last pitch you called? No, you tell who's ever working that brain of yours to turn around and look at me. Okay?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
What was that last pitch? No, you don't! What's Jimmy Dugan's most important rule?
Never vomit on your shoes.
Baseball rule.
There's no crying in baseball.
Sorry?
There's no crying in baseball!
Right! Now, you're missing signs, aren't you, huh? You're playing scared. You're not alert out there. You're not seizing the opportunities. Oh, you're just playing like garbage! Except for you, Betty. That was a terrific pop-up. Stillwell, in my office. Help me off with my spikes.
Well, it was nicer than yesterday.
No. No. Hello? I said, I can't. What do you mean, why? This is... Yeah, I told you last week, no.
I can't go out with you Saturday night.
No, not Sunday neither. Why? Because I'm busy, that's why. I can't... Sarah,
It's your husband.
Hey, that's my new hat. Take that off. Evelyn,
still out, Angel. Give me back that hat. I don't know where it's been.
Well, look who it is. Remember me? I raised you from squalor.
Mr. Cappadino, come in. Man on the floor, more or less.
More man you'll ever know.
Remember me?
Remember you? You haunt my dreams. Ladies, for those of you who haven't had the good fortune to meet me, I am Ernie Cappadino, that's C-A-P-A-D-I-N-O. I used to be a baseball scout, but now I am the right-hand man to Mr. Walter Harvey, maker of Harvey bars, owner of the league, and the man who can destroy your lives with the flick of his wrist.
Why are you here?
And when are you leaving?
Apparently learning to wear shoes has made them irritable.
If you just say what you gotta say, you're stinking up the parlor.
I'll have you know this is a 25-cent cigar.
Who said anything about a cigar?
All right, now, everyone, find a seat and pay attention, because Mr. Harvey's outside in the car, and he's gonna come in here and speak to you. Now, hurry up.
Hey, hey.
Come on. All right, Mr. Harvey, I've settled him down.
That's enough, girl. Sit. Good. Well, normally I would not come down here and intrude on your fascinating personal lives. If I had something to say, I would say it at the ballpark. But this is a delicate matter.
We love you, Mr. Harvey.
You're May, aren't you?
Yeah, and that's more than a name. It's an attitude.
Everything I own's in my wife's name. Sit down. Now, there is no nice way to say this. You peaches have not been performing up to expectations. This is a business. And when your business is going badly, you cut your losses.
Cut your losses?
Last year we had 4 teams. This year we have 6 teams. I'm thinking of going back to 4.
But those new teams are very good.
I know.
Oh, you mean?
That's what I mean. You got 2 weeks to turn this around. End of speech. Good evening, ladies.
2 weeks.
Mr. Harvey, you said that beautifully.
Wait!
What wait?
Oh, come on. Come on. Come on, cow eyes. He's a busy man.
Mommy, I want somebody to read me a story.
What is that, like a child? We hired a child?
It's my son, sir. Whose turn is it?
Well, I think it's May or...
Kit! It's your turn.
No, it isn't.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is. I keep track. Don't I, Betty?
Right?
Okay. All right.
Okay.
All right. Coming.
Raggedy Ann girl, I'm standing here with my hat on. Say something.
Mr. Harvey, I know why we're losing.
I also know why we're losing, because you score fewer runs than the other team.
No, it's Daddy.
Go fire her.
No, she's already gone.
So it's settled.
No, Dottie was our catcher and our best player last season.
Yeah, but she went home to Oregon because her husband came home from the war.
Yeah, now he's back in the Army.
But I think she might want to come back and play.
But what about Kit?
That's why I sent her upstairs.
You see, sir, Kit is Dottie's little sister, and she's always been slightly jealous of Dottie. And if we talk about needing Dottie with Kit here, she gets her feelings hurt, and we like Kit, so we don't want to hurt her feelings.
Mm-hmm. Tell me yes, no. You want Dottie back, you
yes.
don't want Dottie
yes.
back.
Yes, yes, yes. yes.
Happy.
Yes. Yes, I'm right here, sir.
Go out to Oregon and bring back this Dottie person.
Oh, you seem to be forgetting, sir. I don't work the road anymore. No, I'm strictly an inside man.
Nice pen, huh?
Beautiful, sir.
This is the very pen that I sign your paycheck with.
Say, why don't I go outside and get that for you, and on the way back, I can swing by Oregon.
Thank you, Bob.
Bye.
We got Dottie!
Evelyn! Evelyn!
Evelyn, Stillwell wants a cookie.
Coming right up.
We'll be right back after this short break.
A message from Major League Baseball.